Okay. Personally, I feel like this is a perfect curly fro for the fall. It's heatless, protects your edges, everything is protected, and it's simple. You just pop it on when you're ready to go out, beat your face, and you're done. Like, you're popping. And the color is definitely perfect. Take you instantly from village girl to pepper them gang, you know. No shade to my village slay mamas, but you guys get. Just have fun with your looks, you know. I'm gonna be using Brazilian curly hair from Eunice, however you say it. More details in the info section below as usual. And this wig is quite reminiscent of one I've made in the past, but of course with some differences. I'm going to provide more details on everything that I'm using in the information section down underneath this video as well. I'm using a glue gun because it's quick and easy and appropriate for this style of wig, and pretty much glued the hair in circles. One thing I'm doing slightly different this time, I'm leaving like a slight little gap in the cap around the back side. Since no one is going to be seeing it anyway, that pretty much allows for some stretch in the cap just in case you get done making a wig and you feel like it's too tight. And if you feel like the stretch is still enough, you can cut like a slight slit in the cap if needed. It shouldn't damage the whole wig, or rather than you having to make the wig all over again. Also, you want to make sure to get a blockhead that's your head size or, you know, slightly bigger, so that you don't have to worry about the wig not fitting. And I just continue to glue the hair in circles till I closed it all up. Brown skin is better, sketchy, really can be dancing. I'm vibing, chilling, and I'm looking for my brown skin. Brown skin, yeah. Brown skin girl with the highway shorts, looking so righteous. And one thing I'm also doing a little bit differently when it came to closing it up, I cut like a little piece of hair, and I already kind of measured this around the circle to figure out how much hair I'm gonna need to close up the circle. Apply some of the glue to the hole that I have to close up and just stuck the hair that I rolled up in there. I let it dry, used a curly one to make sure it's all flat, and that's it, it's done.
Say my love for you is organic, and that body's so dangerous, and my highway shorts, and I know you wanna cause damage. She's a savage.
I also had some hair left over, so I flipped the wig inside out to glue some hair underneath the cap so that everything is more seamless and the cap is not really visible. And out of the four bundles that I was working with, this is how much hair I had left. There are several ways to go about achieving this particular color. I decided to go for this L'Oreal High Color. This is meant for dark hair so that you wouldn't have to bleach your hair. But when you're using stuff like this, it doesn't really get the hair as vibrant as you would like it, especially in one step. So it kind of defeats the whole purpose anyway. So I went ahead and lightened the end so that that part can be like lighter. And just in case you're wondering, I did use Olaplex. And then I went in with the Sizzling Copper Color, mixed it with the 40 Volume Developer, applied it to the dark parts of the hair first, because I know this color would not get the black hair all the way to a bright copper look, more of like a burgundy look. Let that press for about an hour. Then I went back in with a 20 volume developer and mixed that with the color to apply to the tips. And I used a 20 volume developer because, of course, I've already lightened the ends, so using the 40 volume is kind of pointless. Let it sit for additional 1 hour and went ahead and washed it off. At this point, I was a bit concerned, like, oh my god, this color is not as bright as I want it. So I decided to blow dry it to kind of, you know, be sure before I move forward to curling it. You know, once I blow dried it, I was able to kind of see the true color better. So I was a bit more confident moving forward. So I went ahead and sprayed it so that it can be wet. And I'm going to be using perm rods to curl it. Just so the hair doesn't feel too dry, I applied some one and only argan oil, applied some mousse so that the curls can last even longer.
Entertainment. so kale wow.
Once I was ready to wear the hair, I took out the rods, cut it to shape, fluff it out, and styled it however I wanted to look. Hopefully you guys found this helpful. I'm gonna leave all links and all the list of products that I use in this video. I'm gonna leave them down below in the information section, so be sure to check, and I'll talk to you all later.
NSC, NSC. We popping away. We popping away.